Damn, Twinzy G, what time is it?
I don't know why these plaisies acting like they can't love no female G's. But check this out. It's about 3 a.m. and I need some love, some of that good stuff, that kind of thing that give me a head rush. When I get to the crib, I want you to make me scream and holler. Baby, pop your collar. You can even drop a few of them dollars, but don't bother, just feel me as we caress. I rub your chest, we put this love thing to the test. My nose is wide open, damn, your love got me impressed. And if I hadn't known how you was gonna do it, I would have loved you a whole lot sooner. You touch me, I touch back, we attack. 20 sheets from the back, feel the blast in the dash, roll the grass. Go to the mall, spend a little bit of your cash. Baby, don't hesitate when it's time to get mama some more of that ass. Cause I'm a female gangster and I need love too. Hear what I'm saying, I put it down like this for you. 20 G and JB, now we just saying we got time to get JB, make you feel like a man when you wanna. But if you start to cheating, then you's a goner. Cause I can give you everything you need. See, from your head to your teeth, I got those recipes to satisfy your needs, to make you bounce out of your mind, bring it back one more time, so I can bust another funky rhyme. And for you to press the tape and rewind, won't cost a dime. Now riding for my man is what I do, and keeping the truth top notch is what he do. I thought you knew, coming in red or blue, I'll get busy if I really.
It's the best in throwback hits radio, Mighty G-Force Radio Soul, and we back with another one. My favorite twins, Twinfotainment, JB and my girl, Twinzy G, in the house. What's up, girl?
Hey, Wayne. How you doing?
All good, baby.
We back, baby, and we back stronger than ever. I hope they ready for it.
No doubt.
Welcome. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We appreciate it, and we miss y'all so much.
Yes.
It's so good to be back. It just feels good. It feels good to be in the studio. It feels good to be with my 2020 twins.
Yes.
And we got a special surprise for y'all today. Well, y'all know we've been putting it out there, but today is the day that we finally get the infamous, legendary music, film producer, entrepreneurial, serial entrepreneur mogul, Michael Mosley, y'all, from the Bay Area. He is up in the building.
Yes.
Michael.
Blessing us with that love.
How you doing, Mike? Thank you so much
good.
For joining
how y'all doing,
us.
Family?
We're good. We're good. We're so blessed to have you in our presence tonight or on the phone with us. Yes.
Yes. Same way about you guys.
Oh, thank you.
Well, you know, we want to talk about some of the things that you've done. Now, we have a short period of time. We've been so anxious to get you on our show, Mike. And Twinfotainment TV is just blessed to have you here. So we're grateful. But we know that a lot of people don't, they're like, who is Mike Mosley? Because you so laid back, you're like that MVP that never go to the club or never be on the front line, but you the MVP.
Right. Yes.
So because of that, and the reason why I say you're the MVP is because of all the work you've put in.
Wow.
I mean, you've been putting in work since the 80s, the early 80s,
right.
And it probably goes back before then.
Man,
in your
I miss the 80s. The 80s
right?
And the 90s. Ugh.
Man. But listen, I wanted to tell the people about some of the music that you produced. But before we get into some of that music, Mike, let's talk about how you became the man behind the music. How did you get into music at all?
Well, you know, started DJing, you know, started just like the passion of being a DJ, but I think it started from, you know, being programmed by your mama, you know,
right, I mean? Right.
My mama programmed me with playing the music. We all grew up with a mama playing music, you know?
Yes. Those oldies.
Started, yeah. I think it kind of started with that. And then it started with older cousins programming me with the music that they listened to, like the funk, the George Clinton and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
All of a sudden, you know, I'm like, okay, you know what? I started DJing and met as it was DJing. Chauncey and Chauncey's brother, Petey.
Yeah. Wow.
Chauncey. You know what I mean? They
man, I remember those parties.
Yeah. Yeah. It was DJing. So I'm like, oh, I want to do that. You know what I mean? So we started DJing and, you know, then we tried to figure out how to make these records. Then we started getting equipment. Then we started actually tutelaging and start, you know, tinkering around and,
wow.
You know, then it just turned into something. You know, nobody never really knew what they were doing back then. We were just doing something. You know what I mean?
Yes.
But enjoying what you was doing at the same time.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
That's amazing how something you fall in love with something so small and it turns into something so major in your life. And you're not expecting for it to really it flourished the way it did in your life, and
right.
Boy, did it flourish and blossom and turn into something so big and beautiful.
Yes,
right.
Like you,
and so early too.
Yes,
you know what I mean? It's like, and it, looking back at it, I just realized, I just see all the different fortunate, the path. I just seen the path. Looking back at it now, you know what I mean.
Yeah,
how and why I'm the way I am.
Yes,
you know what I mean.
Such an innovator and an inspiration to so many people. And I can't imagine a lot of people coming from the 707, where we all kind of bumbled from, and not feeling inspired by you and,
right.
and saying, just seeing Mike do it. And seeing
right.
how he, and I didn't even know, like, you had started out with Petey and Chauncey and doing music with them. I just remember coming to the parties. I just remember coming to the parties.
See, what it was is I used to work with Petey.
Okay.
At McDonald's. My first job was with at McDonald's with Petey and Cordelia.
Look at that.
Wow.
So Petey used to go to this dude, this producer, him and Eric Sandals used to be making beats, and Petey would come over there and he would let me hear stuff.
Yeah.
It was like dope, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Of course, Chauncey was with us too, and you know, Chauncey was a DJ too, but we all was in the same, around the same each other, you know what I mean? So Petey was one of my, you know, inspirational people, you know what I mean? Of,
wow.
You know what I mean? And back then, along with the people, you know, everybody I grew up with, you know, Carl, Gigolo, Jack, and Cliff, and
Yes.
You know,
look, you're taking us all the way back.
Well, let's give some shout outs to Petey and Chauncey for just making it all come to existence.
Yes.
Definitely.
Yes. That's straight history. And you know, it's crazy because you guys are all still in one way or another still leading in the community, you know. In one way or another, you made it big in film and music and now entrepreneurship. Petey went off and he did his thing in the music industry. And then I look at Chauncey. He done opened up the store out there in the mall in Fairfield. Funky Chicken. We got to go visit the Funky Chicken.
Yeah.
Shout out to the Funky Chicken. Because if you're from the 707, you better go visit the Funky Chicken at the Fairfield Mall. I'm telling you now. Might sound small to you, but that's a worldwide name right there.
Yeah.
And it stands for something. And, Mike, I know you stand for something. And I know that you work with a lot of people in the industry that a lot of people would probably just kill or die to work with.
Absolutely.
Everybody know you, E-40 was one of your first artists that you was working with. How did it go from doing them shows, the parties with Petey and Chauncey, and then how did it flip into transform into you just literally making it like this is a business. Like,
yeah,
I'm a real producer. Like, I'm making music for albums now. How did it how did that transpire for you?
I think that, you know, once E40 them got a professional, you know, a major label deal, that just opened it up to doing real business. You know, I mean, we were doing business on an independent level, but once you cross over into international companies, you know, multi-million dollar companies partnering up with you, with your brands, that's when you, yeah, that's when they so-called solidify you. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And so, yeah, it's, and so all kind of other entities come into play, like publishing companies, radio stations, all these other entities that have to pay you and have to make you sign contracts to you know, collect your monies and stuff, because it's all, it's a real business.
Right.
It didn't really start until, you know, 40 and B and them got, you know, they got their deal, was sick with it, and yeah, started, you know, and brought us along with that whole thing. You know, we all came up together. So
wow. That's, you know, that's some
took us in there.
Real 707 love right there, huh?
That's amazing story though. Like, it's just funny. It just sound like, you know, you went from doing something you love in the comfort of your home, jamming out a few house parties, to now this person got a real record deal with a major label, and now I need all those all those songs that those producers did. I need paperwork on them now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
so it kind of turned mm-hmm. you into, okay, so now how did that roll over? Did that help you in your business as a producer and moving forward after you start doing work for 40 and Jive and Sick With It Records? Did that help you be more professional with the other artists that you were working with?
Right.
Yeah, it did. I mean, you had to be, you know what I mean? You had to do paperwork and, you know what I mean? Because you were a business. So you try and do more business with other people that were having major record labels. I mean, major real artists, you know, mm-hmm. professional artists.
Well, everyone, we just wanted to let y'all know that we just wanted to give y'all a little taste of what's coming. And it's going to be so big. It's going to be so exciting. And we just want to tell y'all a little bit. We just wanted to share a little bit with you guys about this interview we're about to have with Mike Mosley. This is major, y'all. This is a major dude. This is a major figure. And we are so blessed to have him on our show, Twinfotainment. And thank you so much. And I just appreciate it.
Yes, yes, yes. And I am so excited that he even took the time. So listen, the reason why I'm saying that is because people don't realize the work he's put in.
It's a major factor.
And like y'all heard, this started years before he even got professional.
Yeah.
It's like so amazing because we got to see some of those early years,
yes,
with Petey Banks and Chauncey Banks and the parties and the,
that's all amazing. That. I was like, I didn't even realize you were doing all that stuff with them. But now that I think back, I can remember they were all at the parties, doing these parties together. And I just know we used to go in there and act a fool. It was like they was playing the music for us. We was always the party starters.
A party
ain't a party till I run through it. That part.
Yes. Indeed. But you know, what I wanted to say was, he started out at them house parties,
mm-hmm.
and was rocking the party to like the LL Cool J's and the Run DMC.
Right.
I mean, he was playing all the hip hop stuff.
Yeah.
But then he crossed over and started making music.
Right.
And we kind of got into that. You know, he worked with E40. Y'all heard a little bit. We played a little bit. But let's just talk about some of the tracks that he's produced. No, let's talk about some of the awards that he has won. We can kind of
2 times, 10 times, 4 times, 3 times
platinum
albums. So that right there speaks for itself.
Major
Figures is not going platinum 10 times.
But what we have to do is give y'all the receipts. So I'm gonna give you the artist and the album and what he received. Okay, Tupac Shakur, All Odds, Me Against the World, 2 times platinum. Tupac Shakur, All Eyes on Me, 10 times platinum and diamond.
Yeah. Okay?
Tupac Shakur, Are You Still Down? 4 times diamond. Tupac Shakur, Until the End of Time, 3 times platinum.
Yeah.
I mean, not platinum, the 4 times platinum, 3 times platinum, 1 time platinum, E-40 in a major way, E-40 Hall of Fame, 500K. He went gold, y'all.
I don't even think Mike was ready for what was coming his way.
But wait, Jay-Z, the Dynasty album.
Yeah. Major.
2 times platinum.
Major factor.
Yeah.
Major factor.
TQ, 5,000K, 500K. They Never Saw It Coming by TQ. Y'all remember TQ? Mystical. Come on now. Mystical. 1 time platinum. The Unpredictable album. And he's also produced so many albums on the West Coast, y'all. Like I said, he is the legend of the Bay.
Yeah.
And if you from the Bay,
he's worked
to LA,
with Sebo and Selly Cell and Marvelous.
And
I mean, he's done some major stuff and has really helped a lot of artists find a route, you know, find a route and mm-hmm. and know which way they're going. He helped people build their artistry
and working with producers like Rick Rock, who is now working with artists like Snoop Dogg and other major artists, and he even has his own album out. I mean, like, everyone has seemed to really just evolve through this music game because they started to take it serious and treat it as a business.
Yes.
So let that be a lesson to y'all out there, because if you're not taking it serious and you're not treating it as a business, what right. are you really doing it for? Just
right.
to be flossing on people? Just to say you got something? But you know what? We gonna get some more into it. What we gonna do is we gonna play a clip or two of some of the films that Mike has produced, because we ain't even got into
Mike is
the
so
other
major.
Work that he has done, and not even his entrepreneur endeavors.
Yes,
he got some big smoke coming up, y'all. He got some big smoke coming, but y'all ain't ready. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. We're gonna get into a little bit of Tupac's. Well, we can even show a little bit of All Eyes on Me because he produced them. Directed that film.
Yes.
Okay? So we'll be back. We're gonna play a little bit of All Eyes on Me and get into some of his other productions that he's worked on here recently. And we'll be right back with Twinfotainment Web TV, powered by GFN Radio. So
see you guys soon.
You are listening to Mighty G Force Radio Soul, the best and throwback hits radio.
It's the station that rocks 24/7.
And make sure you get our Fire TV app. And also, our Roku TV app is GFN Radio Soul. Let's jam, baby.
Knocking down the competition with the hottest certified hip hop and R&B mixes.
You are listening to Mighty G Force Radio Soul, the best and throwback hits radio.
Def Jam. Def Jam.
Mighty G Force Radio Soul, and we back for the break with my girls, Twinfotainment, man. This show is going to be off the chain, man. This brother done a lot. And most you people, you can even understand that you listen to a lot of things that this person did over the years.
Yeah.
So I want y'all to kind of get in depth and get to see the man behind the music and behind the movies. Yo, Twinfotainment, take it away.
Hey, thank you so much, Wayne G. And thank y'all so much for tuning back in to your favorite twins at Twinfotainment Web TV, because we are back and we are stronger and we are greater than ever, baby. And we ain't going nowhere. So I hope y'all understand that you can leave us a request. If you would like to hear an interview, if you would like to see us somewhere out on the location, all you have to do is send us a request. We have our own personal request line, baby. You can text us or leave us a voicemail at 469 um, 469-857-9646. That's 469-857-9646.
Are you sure?
That's our private line, baby. That's 24/7. That's
COVID line.
Ain't no COVID.
I'm just come here. Call us. Get your COVID shot.
No, you might get a COVID shot. But
you was hesitating that number. Like, you know, did you forget or something?
Well, I sort of forgot because
it's been a while.
It's a new number.
Yeah.
See, we have to switch some things up. But that is our new Twinfotainment request line. If you want to be a guest on our show, if you have something that you'd like to share with the world, if you'd like to have your music play.
Yeah.
If you have an event coming up in the community, if you have a job that you're soliciting and you'd like to do a hiring fair or whatever the case
job
may be,
yeah.
We have advertisement available for you. We have marketing available for you, and we do promotions, and we also do campaigns, call center campaigns. So
yes.
Reach out to us. And by the way, those girls over there at TAS Logistics, they got that dispatching popping. So if you know some owner operators that need
big
some real dispatching,
drivers.
Hit up that TAS Logistics dispatching because they got it popping, y'all. And again, you can find out more about them by texting 469-857-9646 at Twinfotainment's hotline.
And we don't want no ex-pimps calling talking about I need to hire some girls.
Like, we ain't doing none of that over
yeah,
there.
You know,
we
when you say a job fair, everybody think they got a legal business.
We can put them to work too.
Yeah.
We can put them to work too.
Yeah. You can work the board.
Yeah, definitely.
But yes, getting back to our topic at hand though, again, we really enjoy having Mike Mosley on today. He was such a treat.
Yeah.
And I hope y'all enjoyed him. And again, you better go Google that man behind the music and the film because he's done so much
Major.
Over the years. And it's just like his catalog is getting longer and longer and longer. And now that he's into the whole CBD ice cream
mm-hmm.
and he's getting ready to open up a CBD shop.
That's what I really like about him. He let
yeah.
it transpire into something a lot major. He'll
just get locked in to one thing.
He took it from music to producing movies, opening up hemp stores.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah, doing it.
If you're not inspired by this man, then you just not wanting to get in the game. That's all I can say. Because
listen,
this is the one. And what another thing I like to say, the newer producers are getting all the love, but they're not playing the music, the real music that the older producers, the more seasoned and
mm-hmm.
and producers that have that longevity.
Right.
They have the love in the music.
Yeah.
Right now, it's all about the fuck in the music. So, excuse my language.
But basically,
it's all about...
Yeah.
She said,
"How we gonna get it on instead of how can I get my party on?"
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I just miss that.
What
kind
of songs
music.
That you wanna you really think you would like to see being played more today that they don't really do?
Like I said, I miss the 80s and the 90s.
Yeah,
if they brought the 80s and the 90s music back
mm.
and tell stories. Again.
Yeah, yeah.
See,
once upon a time,
music,
not long ago.
When you tell a story in a song, it helps people grow. It helps people, you know, get through things
and identify with what you went through while you wrote the song or while you telling the story.
Yes.
It's kind of put you in my seat in the get you out of the passenger seat and put you in the driver's seat to get to see my vision.
Yes.
Wasn't the message like a national anthem for the black people? Don't
oh
push
my
me.
God!
Cause
yeah.
no matter where you came from, every hood
and we knew
had
that
same
song
experience
from beginning to
yeah.
end.
Yeah, every
no,
city.
The
had
one
that
song,
same.
Wayne.
Uh huh.
The one song everybody knew that you, if you said it at the wrong auntie house, you might have got a whooping because she knew you was talking about her macaroni and cheese, the peas, all soggy, and the chicken.
It tastes like wood.
Yeah.
Yes, I love it. All of those artists, the Grandmaster Flashes and the and the LL Cool J's and the these are artists. These are the real artists. Yeah. They told stories. The E40s. I mean, E40's still in the music. He's still relevant. Don't get me wrong, but
right.
The thing we want to hear them telling these stories. That's what make music exciting.
Yeah.
And but you know,
it, but
fruitful.
It would, but it would keep our kids out of jail.
Yes.
So the industry doesn't find a play for that anymore. You know, every conscious rapper that put out something that spoke to the hood, they didn't make it.
That's
you know
exactly.
what I'm saying? They did not make it. I mean, you know,
want the Tupac.
I was telling people, you know,
they don't want that positivity.
When Pac put that song, Brenda Had a Baby, he basically put something out way ahead of the time that it really was happening frequently. It's almost like he foretold the future with that song, Brenda Had a Baby, you know, and a lot of
you know, 15,000 Brendas.
And if you were Brenda, if you were Brenda out there, it really helped you become a better person or want to be a better person
or reach out to somebody.
Because it definitely didn't help the Brenda he rapped about.
Exactly.
She was found in a dumpster.
Are you serious?
Yeah, in the song.
In the song?
Yeah, like
you scared me because I was like, Brenda be doing mid-video.
No, because she was saying, like, you know, she was found dead, you know,
dead in the
prostitute dead, you know what I'm saying?
It so, damn sure didn't turn out good for Brenda.
Yeah, it didn't turn out good for Brenda.
But that was a real serious message, and like you said, if we can just start getting back to telling
to the
stories.
Story. And, what happened to the story?
And giving that lineage and our history and our music. And let's educate people and uplift each other more in our music.
And come back with them funky bass lines.
Yeah, instead of all that killing and stuff and, you know,
having
clubbing.
Sex on the songs. I mean, all that is fine. You know, for certain occasions, we do want to hear the love songs. That's, you know, let's talk about the sex, baby.
Right,
let's talk about, you know, we need to hear that.
JB, you real loose today.
But she telling the real.
Yeah, but she been talking.
And y'all tell us. Y'all tell us what y'all think.
She been saying, she been holding it up. We talk about, don't push me. She back to the
fucking grind. Because that's where we at in this world's music today.
Yeah.
But I want to let my children, 14 and 15, listen to the radio because, and I know they do anyway, but for me to just turn the radio on in the car while we cruising like I would if back in the 80s and the 90s.
Right.
I used to bump Tupac and all that story.
But even love songs today is real scary. You know,
they're sketchy.
Sketchy. She ain't nothing but a hoe. I love her.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing but it goes all the way.
Stick it in and slide it and push baby to it. Can't you
But what I want to know from our audience is, what is the kind of music that y'all would like to hear coming from our station?
Yeah.
Because, see, I'm an old school. Like she said, I'm an old head.
And we jammed.
And I could go back. I like old school R&B. Now, I want to hear the 90s and the 80s rap and hip-hop. But give me some of that 80s, 90s
Yes, Mike
R&B
Mosley
soul.
Producing it.
So, you know, let us know what y'all would like to hear on the station,
definitely,
on the show, because we can play whatever. I mean, we DBS, we out there. We in them streets.
Yeah.
So, it might be your music that you want to hear on
the
show.
Can we play their music?
We can play your music. We can play their music.
Right.
We can play our music. And we will be playing our music, as a matter of fact. So, y'all just sit back and enjoy, because you never know.
We got the radio station.
You never know who might jump up on up on our channel. Who might join us in the studio?
We
have Mike Mosley.
So many great nights coming for you guys. We have a lot of great guests that are going to be with us. Mike Mosley was just a little teaser.
Yes.
That was just a teaser for the pleasers. I'm telling y'all, we are coming strong and we are excited about it. It's going to be a great, great year. And so we just want y'all to tune in with us and hang in there, you know, and let's start talking about things. Let's get things out in the open need to be talked about.
Let's just talk about
We're going to talk about everything, the good, the bad, the ugly, the pretty, the successful, the people that are hurting and need. We want to talk about it all.
Exactly. And we want to get in the community too. See what's cracking out there, because you know what? Without the community, we wouldn't be here because we are the people's choice radio. Like, the community choose us.
The station for the people. 24/7.
We are the station for the people. So,
and get
we
ready, GFN, Twinfotainment are coming your way. So you're gonna see us out in those streets, beating those streets, and talking to our people and finding out what's going on in the community. We're out here. We want to know what's going on because we want to help. We want to solve problems. We want to be there for you guys. So as long as y'all are here for us, we're going to be there for you. And, you know, just have fun. Let's have fun with this.
Yeah.
No doubt. Absolutely. So we will catch you on the next one. Twinfotainment. My main girl, Twinzy G. And my main girl, JB. Looking
we
good.
We love you guys.
Like some buttermilk pancakes, I hop on that, some shots of that cognac. Got me going crazy, what you love? That face in the pillow, bite the sheets like moaning. Sex in the air, you can smell it in the building. Put the kids to sleep just to wake up the children. Got you running like faucet water. Pipe down, put that thing out of order, come on.
Go up and down, back and forth, turn me around. I'ma make you say, ooh, it's not high. I'ma make you sing, I'ma make it rain. Right here, right now, on everything. Come here, baby, put your hands in mine. Take this shit with me, I'm about to blow your mind. I'm climbing, teeth grinding, you know I'm saying. I'm about to blow your mind. Yeah. Climbing, teeth grinding, losing eyes.